What if I told you that human-machine interaction could be like that of Tony Stark and Jarvis in the Iron Man movies? While it will probably be a while until we get access to flying exosuits, we can still draw inspiration from them and try to explore applications into aviation. To do so, let us first explain how pilot flying works. Pilots typically rely on two dominant cues, vision and equilibrium. Visual references, such as the horizon, are used by the pilot to understand the aircraft orientation in space. However, in poor visibility conditions, like for example flying through the clouds or flying at night, makes these visual references limited or absent, such that the pilot is much harder for the pilot to determine the aircraft orientation in space. This is why the pilot also uses its vision to read the aircraft instruments, like for example the artificial horizon. Equilibrium, on the other hand, is used to detect sudden changes in the aircraft motion but fails for very slow movements or when accelerations are prolonged and are as strong as gravity. So for example, when flying in zero gravity conditions and with no visual references, a pilot will not be able to tell which way is up and which way is down. However, Tony Stark perceives the motion of the Iron Man suit in another two ways: through advanced haptic systems that enable Stark to feel tactile sensations across his body, and also with auditory cues, like, "Tony, you're flying too fast." So how can we use sensory cues to augment the pilot perception in such a way to create a super pilot? Or can we use the secondary sensory cues to supplement for impaired or denied vision? Can we fly by feel without the use of vision? On the evening of July 16, 1999, John F. Kennedy Jr., his wife, Carolyn, and her sister, Lauren, embarked on a flight from New Jersey to Martha's Vineyard on a Piper Saratoga light aircraft. What should have been a routine journey turned into a harrowing ordeal. As the night wore on, the weather conditions deteriorated, engulfing the surroundings in a thick shroud of low visibility. While darkness obscuring the view, the pilot was forced to rely heavily on its instruments for vital information about the aircraft altitude, orientation, and heading. As the aircraft entered the slow and unperceivable right turn, it started gradually descending into a graveyard spiral. The discordance between the vestibular sensation of the pilot and the instrument readings confused the pilot and compromised its ability to discern what was reality and what was the illusion created by its senses. The pilot's compromised situational awareness resulted in the pilot's inability to correct the aircraft trajectory, ultimately leading to a tragic end. The Piper Saratoga crashed into the Atlantic Ocean near Martha's Vineyard, Massachusetts, soon after. So what if JFK Jr. flew the Piper Saratoga while wearing an Iron Man suit, capable of tactile and auditory feedback? Could this accident be avoided? This is what we're trying to find out at the Extended Reality Flight Simulation and Control Laboratory at University of Maryland. Imagine we could provide the pilot with information about the aircraft motion across its body through tactile feedback. Luckily, we can do so with the Tesla suit, which you can see in my back. I know you're wondering, and no, it's not produced by Tesla. Okay. A Tesla suit is a full-body haptic suit designed to provide haptic sensations across the pilot body through electric muscular stimulation. Tactile sensations range from very gentle, like feeling the rain on your skin, as well as very strong, like an electroshock, which comes in very handy whenever we have to punish our students when they don't perform well in class. Of course, I'm just kidding, but maybe not so much. So let us try to contextualize the use of the suit into aviation. Take the JFK Jr. crash as an example. We do not want the aircraft to go in an uncontrolled right turn. Then, for example, if the aircraft is rolling to the right, we'll have to find a way to tell the pilot, "Hey, roll back to the left." So this can be achieved through proportional derivative compensation. That is, if the aircraft starts rolling right, and it should not, then a tactor will light up on the suit with an intensity that is proportional to how much the aircraft is leaning to the right. We can also add another layer of complexity by making the intensity on the tactor proportional to how fast the aircraft is rolling to the right. So for example, if the aircraft starts rolling to the right very gently, then the pilot will only feel a light sensation. On the other hand, if the aircraft starts rolling to the right particularly abruptly, then the pilot will feel a very strong sensation. But now the question is, where do we make the pilot feel these tactile sensations across the body? So for example, if the aircraft is rolling to the right, and again, it should not, we should make the pilot feel a sensation on its left shoulder to indicate that the pilot should make a corrective action to roll back to the left. If the aircraft is either rolled to the right too much or is rolling to the right too fast, then a second tactor on the upper arm will light up to tell the pilot, hey, you should really roll back to the left, otherwise we're in trouble. The same concept is applied if the aircraft is rotating in the other direction, left wing down. In this case, a tactor on the right shoulder will light up, and if the turn is particularly steep or too abrupt, then a second tactor will light up on the pilot's right shoulder. This cueing strategy is shown in this video, where my student, Michael, is testing the algorithm on himself while being blindfolded. This means that Michael is not seeing the screen like you guys are, but it's only relying on the sensations provided by the Tesla suit to understand what it should do to make a corrective action whenever the aircraft rolls right or left. The indicator you see on the bottom left indicates the desired bank angle, which is designed to constantly change throughout the simulation. The green line, on the other hand, indicates the actual bank angle of the aircraft. And the goal for Michael is to keep the green line within the purple lines at all times. And let me tell you, it's not an easy task, even by using the aid of vision. Nonetheless, Michael does a great job at it. Here's Michael testing another similar algorithm. Oh, pardon. That uses facial audio instead of full body haptics. So let's hear it. OK, so I know what you guys were thinking it sounded like. So, jokes apart, not only is our hope in this research to make aviation safer, but also more inclusive. Through tactile feedback and spatial audio cueing, we can help visually impaired individuals navigate and interact with the aviation environment. This way, visually impaired individuals can actively participate in aviation activities, including flight training, simulation, and recreational experiences. Ultimately, multimodal cueing empowers them to engage with aviation in a more independent and immersive manner, fostering their confidence and interest in the field. In the case you still do not believe us, we have prepared a live demonstration of one of our experiments. So please welcome the haptic knout. So three, two, oh, there we go. Three, two, one, let us start our experiment. This is a 45-second experiment in which our haptic knout is trying to regulate the attitude of an aircraft. Let me emphasize the fact that the haptic knout is not seeing the screen as all of you are, but is only relying on the sensations that it feels across his body. So let us admire the performance of the haptic knout and see how it does. We still should have about 20 seconds of simulation, so I will be counting down. We have about another 10 seconds of simulation, and we're seeing that the haptic knout is doing pretty well. It's over. So let us see how the haptic knout did. So our haptic knot scored a 97% in adequate performance and 60% in desired performance. This is a remarkable performance. Thank you, Mr. Haptic Knot. So going back to the original question, can we fly by feel without the use of vision? I'll let you make up your own mind. Thanks.